Adam and Eve were hanging out in the garden, and as they were sitting together, Eve had this suspicious look to her as she was gazing at Adam. And Adam says, "What's going on?" Eve said, "Are you seeing someone else?" Adam's like, "You are the only woman in the entire world. Of course I'm not seeing someone else." They continued to sit there, and that didn't satisfy Eve, and she still had this look of dissatisfaction on her face, but still glaring at Adam. Adam said, "What are you doing now?" "Counting your ribs," said Eve. This brings us to today's scripture about Adam and Eve being formed in the garden. I'll be reading from the second chapter of Genesis. "Then the Lord God said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make him a helper who is just right for him.' So the Lord God formed from the ground all the wild animals and all the birds of the sky. He brought them to the man to see what he would call them, and the man chose a name for each one. He gave names to all the livestock, all the birds of the sky, and all the wild animals. But there was no helper just right for him. So the Lord God caused the man to fall into a deep sleep. While the man slept, the Lord God took out one of the man's ribs and closed up the opening. And the Lord God made a woman from the rib, and he brought her to the man." So this passage, in my opinion, has everything to do with companionship. But before we get to woman being formed from man, let's take a look at what God did first. And that was create the animals, all the livestock, the flying birds, everything, God says, was created. And then God gave Adam the opportunity. He gave humanity the opportunity to name them. Now, that might not seem like a big deal, but think about when we name something, especially something alive and living, whether it be a pet or whether it be a livestock animal on the farm, whether it be our child. When we name something, we are giving it attention. We are acknowledging its existence, its lifeblood. So that's what God gave Adam the opportunity to do. And Adam realized that when he was naming them, that he is in and we are in coexistence with all of creation. And yet, as we know, we love animals. We love our companions. We love our pets. I love my dogs. I love my goldfish. I love my dogs more than my goldfish. Sometimes I think my wife loves the dogs more than me. And at times I'll say that is fair on her account because I can be difficult. But even yet, as much as we love animals, something still is missing. Something is still yearning from our life. And we see that in this passage with Adam as well. Like he says, "Yes, God, these animals are great. I got Fido here and I got the giant elephant I can ride. But something is still missing. I need that helper," he says. "I need that companion, that person. I need a person who is like me." You know, we can have our dogs and cats, but we still yearn for that human connection and relationship. And if you didn't realize, there are two different creation accounts in the book of Genesis. There's one in chapter 1 and there's one in chapter 2 that tell us how man and woman and humanity come into existence. In Genesis 1, man and woman are created simultaneously in the image of God. In chapter 2, we have Adam being formed first and then Eve being formed from the rib of a man. Both stories are not in direct contradiction to one another, but both have an ability to teach us, and we can learn from them. And what I see in this passage is that woman being formed from man, and this isn't about patriarchy, this isn't about who came first or who's better, that is not anything that I read in this passage. What I see is the companionship, the desire for another human being to have that same interaction, that same connectedness, to share in relationships, to explore life, to endure, to celebrate the high points and to be with one another and to support one another during the lows of our lives. To me, this passage clearly tells us that we, man, woman, are not created to be alone. We desire that soulmate, that person that we are to be with and to explore life, that we are not created to be alone. And I know hearing that now, especially during this time of pandemic and social distancing and isolation and quarantining, and maybe you are watching this and your spouse has already gone on to be with the Lord, or maybe you're single. And my heart goes out to all those that are yearning and desperately desiring that human connection. Like I said, especially during this time of pandemic, But there are better days ahead. There are better days in the here and the now as we see the vaccine being disseminated, which will hopefully lend itself to us going back to some sort of normalcy as it was before. I don't think life will ever be the same, but hopefully we will be back to being in personal and direct relationship with other people very, very soon. But also, as we yearn and miss our loved ones that have gone before us, as we celebrate on All Saints Day, we know that we will be reunited with him once again in heaven, and our companions will be by our side. Friends, you're all in my thoughts and my prayers. I hope this message finds you and yours safe and healthy. I hope you're getting the care and attention that you need. Know that you are not alone, that God is always with you, that Christ is always with you. And may God be with you until we meet again.